Hi, welcome to Tommy's Trade Secrets. This short clip is all about plastering and how to do it right, so hopefully you'll find it useful. Take a look at the step-by-step guide, and if you like it, print it, keep it, and of course use it.
Hi, my name's Simon from TradeSupermarket.com, and today I'm going to teach you how to render a block wall like this. Okay, so the tools needed for this job are a plasterer's bath, a feather edge, a shovel, a couple of builder's buckets, a hawk, a scratching tool, a steel float, some snips, a large brush, and a plastic float. You want to get yourself some protective gloves as well. Right, okay, as you can see, we've got a few things in our way. It's an alarm system, so this can't be removed. So what we're going to do is cover them up with a plastic bag so they don't get too ruined by the render. Right, so as you can see, our blocks and our frame are flush with each other, so it's not an option to use angle beads on this. So what we're going to do is use a stop bead and run it up exactly level with our frame. So what we want to do, we're going to mark off just at the top where the end of our frame is, and then cut with your snips. Right, so okay, you want a good set of snips, and where our line is, just want to cut it straight on that bit, and then give it a little snip there as well. All we want to do is just bend it until it breaks off. Right, okay, so now it's time to fix our bead. I'm just using 30mm galvanised nails, but if you're going to brickwork, you might want to get yourself some masonry nails. Right, remember, when fixing it, you want to keep it nice and level with your frame, if that's what you're doing, and put as many fixings in as possible. You don't want it all loose or flappy. Well, as you can see here, we've got ourselves a pre-stressed concrete lintel, which our normal nails and masonry nails will probably not go into. So the only way around this is to either drill and plug it, or to use some of this, some grab adhesive, and just put a few blobs all the way along. Right, okay, so now that's on there, we're going to fix our bead to it. I'm just going to give it a slight wiggle so it takes to it, and wipe off any excess. Right, okay, as you can see, we've got some timber on the end of our block wall, so we're going to need to cover up some EML to bridge the gap. Obviously your cement won't adhere to that and it'll just crack and fall off. So you want to make sure you get enough on each side and make sure you put plenty of fixings in it, and that should keep you out of trouble. Right, okay, so all our walls prepped, now it's just time to knock up our sand and cement. I'm using the 411 mix, which is just 4 parts sand, 1 part cement, 1 part water. Also, we're using it on an internal wall here, so we don't need any waterproofer, but if you're using an external wall, it's best to get yourself some of that and follow the instructions. Right, so basically what you want to do when knocking it in the plasterer's bucket is just keep transferring it from one side to the other without no water until we get all the sand and cement binding together, and then we'll show you what to do then. Right, okay, now you can see that it's all bind it together nicely, so now it's just time to add water. Remember not to add too much at each time, and just do it till you get a nice creamy texture. The same again, we're going to transfer it from one side to another until we get the desired texture we want.
I hope you found that useful. Now click below to find all the tools and materials you need for the job. There are products from loads of merchants, all at the cheapest prices on the web. Thanks very much for watching Tommy's Trade Secrets. Oh, would you mind rating this video and spread the word?